Hello everyone, welcome to today's webinar all about Kant approach in homeopathy and its practical utility. So let us start with the seminar. First we will go through his biography. Kant was born on 31st March 1849 in Woodland, New York, attended the Institute of Electric Medicine in Cincinnati, Ohio, where in addition to the standard medicine, he also learned naturopathy, homeopathy, and chiropractic. Chiropractic is a practice which used to deal with the muscular disorders. In 1874, Kant married to his first wife, Ellen, and settled in St. Louis, Missouri, where he started his medical practice. His first wife died earlier at the age of 19. In 1878, Kant married to her second wife, Lucy. In spite of that, Lucy suffered from nervous weakness, insomnia, anemia, being treated by both the orthodox medicine and elective fusion, but was not getting any relief. She was bedridden completely. Dr. Kant's wife, Lucy, requested him to consult to a homeopathic physician, Dr. Richard Phelan, which was quite famous at that time, and she was treated by Dr. Phelan, and she did a remarkable and dramatic recovery. Kant was so impressed by the results, so he started showing his interest towards homeopathy, and this was probably the reason why he came to homeopathy. So his journey towards homeopathy started from here. Some of his important works I want to show you people. Lectures on Homeopathy Philosophy in 1900. Lectures on Homeopathy Materia Medica in 1905. Most famous one was Repertory of Homeopathic Materia Medica in 1897. Kant views of Bonnighausen Repertory. As we all know, Bonnighausen was the first who wrote the repertory. He wasn't that satisfied with the Bonnighausen repertory. He found that it is very difficult to separate a modality of a part to that modality of a patient to that of a part. It was quite difficult to separate them. So he didn't find that his repertory, Bonnighausen repertory, so useful in his practice, but he liked the concept of grand generalization. So what was Kant's concept of totality? I want to show you. Mind was given more importance in Kant's repertory. Kant was the first person who was giving more importance to mind as compared to the physical and generals. Will, love, anger, hate, fear was included. Perversion of understanding. He was the first person to understand the hallucination, illusion, and delusion through homeopathy. Perversion of memory, absent-minded forgetfulness, mistakes in writing. Physical journals were also included. Some particulars were included. Some very good peculiar symptoms we can find in Kant repertory. How to differentiate a medicine? Kant used thermals and thrust to differentiate a medicine, whereas Bonnighausen used to differentiate the mind to differentiate the bodies. These are the two different approaches by both our pioneers. There are 32 chapters in Kant report. I will show you a case, a simple case of a 57-year-old female suffering with menorrhagia headache since 3 months. She was very loquacious. The only peculiar symptom I found is during her menses she has nausea and eating aggravate headache. This was another peculiar. She was very chilly. She used to wear a sweater in the summer season as well. So what will be the analysis? So this was the analysis. Only three rubrics I have taken: mind, loquacity, stomach, nausea, menses during, and another rubric: pain, headache in general, forehead in eating aggravate. So these three rubrics I have taken, and only two medicines are coming. One is coculus and another is phosphorus. So as we all know from our knowledge of Materia Medica, Coculus is a hot remedy, whereas Phosphorus is a chilly remedy. So I will give a chilly remedy. So I have given Phosphorus, 30 OD for 7 days, and she did quite well in Phosphorus. Another case I want to show you, this case is of my guru, Dr. Jiten Jain. This was a case of a 6-year-old boy suffering from insanity. Cause wasn't that much prominent, we didn't found it. Only she was doing laughing involuntary, and only PPR symptom which her mother told her, she used to urinate outside the pot during her insanity period. This is the only PPR symptom we found in this case. So how we will repertorize to this case, we will check out. So how we will repertorize? Only three rubric in this case also I have taken. Delirium laughing, this I have taken. Delirium urinates outside the pot, which include only one medicine, that is Belladonna. insanity, madness with. Only these 3 rupees I am taking, and you can see the single medicine which is coming out is Belladonna. So Belladonna, 30 potency single dose I have given, and she did well. Some of the interesting rupees I want to show you people, I want to demonstrate you people. Okay, I want to demonstrate. That is first rupee ever. Abusive, angry without being. That is of Dalkamar. I have used in one patient. Her husband told her that my wife मेरे को ऐसा बोलती है ना, गुस्सा नहीं करती है लेकिन कुछ ऐसा बोल देती है ना जिसको ऐसा लगता है जैसे गाली दे रही, कभी मेरे कलर के बारे में कमेंट कर देगी, कभी मेरी इनकम के बारे में बोल देगी कि देखो तुम्हारा वो दोस्त कितना अच्छा कमा रहा है, तुम कैसा कमा रहे हो. तो ये मेरे को काफ़ी तकलीफ देता है ये सब सारी चीज़ें. सो आई हैव गिवन हर डलका मारा. अनदर थिंग, logging good opinion. This was a case of a small girl, 10 years. She always wanted, her core was that she wanted to be good in everyone's eyes. So I have given a palladium, single medicine can be good. Let's go fast. Mistake is speaking. Mistake speaking when you are not intended. Mistake speaking intended, but he was not. He used to speak something which he didn't intend to do. Single medicine, I don't know. I have given him, I don't know. This all I have used in different cases. I will try to show you all. Okay, difference. Okay, this is an interesting rubric. Okay, difference. Reverence for those around him. This was a small child of 6-7 years came to my clinic, and she first respected my wish my attender, and after that she wished me in such a honorful way. I couldn't tell you. I gave him hemamelis. His totality came out the hemamelis, and when it was lack of reverence, we can think of anacardium and cholecystitis. Open delirium. This was a case of my sir. It was a case of a coma case. I want to show you the coma. It was like a coma case. Patient was in hospitalized and she doesn't blink her eyes. Her eyes was continuously open, like this. Continuously open, and my sir gave her stramonium, 1 mg single dose, and she did well. I remember this case. Another rubric, I should not sleep with him. Yeah, I remember this case. This was a case of multiple sclerosis, and he used to twitch his shoulder during sleep. He used to twitch his shoulder. We came, gave him hyoscyamus, and I remember he did well in hyoscyamus. Yeah, this was the case. Eye itching, coryza during. You know, I found this very peculiar symptom. It's of capsicum. Eye itching, coryza during. It's of capsicum. Nose coryza, sitting up amidships. Coryza, sitting up amidships. Nose coryza sitting up amidships. It's of Macarbus synapis nigra. We have given in synapis nigra by seeing this symptom. Okay, so that's all I know about the Kent repertory. I want to show reverence to all my gurus who taught me so much about homeopathy. There are so many. You can contact me at nishant25smilebox@gmail.com and do subscribe to my channel.